The church finds itself in the era of the fourth technological revolution, wherein events coverage has become the key for members and communities to receive up-to-date and accurate information timeously. The communications department, under the leadership of Elder Melusi Ndlalambi, worked tirelessly in covering conference events. This year, the conference is also able to do video recording and showing highlights of the events that were taking place over the years. This is Melusi from the TOC Communications and Media Office. We are at Sed Haven, where we're still enjoying the convention for the laity. Greetings, Mfundisi.
Good evening to you.
Tell us about your involvement in this convention today.
From morning up to a short while ago, I was working with the subject of how to conduct effective Bible studies.
With the worldwide theme of building bridges of hope, the whole purpose of the department is to bring the gospel on the doorstep or at the bedside of those who cannot make it to our church meetings. Greetings, Mfundisi, and how are you?
Greetings, man. By the Lord's grace, we are fine.
Wonderful. Tell us about what has been happening today at Sed Haven, the laity convention. What is this all about?
Yeah, this is a first of its kind where we organized and conducted. It's called the Festival of the Laity. It's a conference-wide event where we have invited members from all churches in the conference to come and be equipped now that we are preparing ourselves for total member involvement.
Baptism, it is the great commission of Jesus. After we have made them like God, the Bible says, we must then teach them. And when they believe, we must baptize them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost.
My name is Mbuyiseni Mahlango. I am the incoming pastor in the new district that has been formed today.
We all agree that the most compelling imperative is that we unite and move forward. Sanity, composure, compactness must be restored, and God's church must take the upward trajectory and move ever onward and also on the upward way.
We've mocked and derided each other here and across, you know, on the other line. We have made insinuations and many innuendos. Listen to that one. Innuendos. I didn't say Nando's, Pastor Balagalade. I said innuendos. We have made those things against each other. We have verbally and emotionally abused each other.
Through live streaming, thousands of people across the conference and the whole world are able to tune in and experience our programs in real time. Conference events are also fully captured on pictures and are shared on our Facebook pages. In brief, the communications department has set up and upgraded major social media platforms. This involves regular Facebook updates with news, stories, promotional and inspirational video clips and posters. The department has also opened and maintained a new conference YouTube channel. The department has also provided live streaming services for key conference events via Facebook and YouTube. The department also created and supported the development of an online contact database for churches. And the department has been very instrumental in supporting video update reports as the ones you've watched in this session. It is our prayer and our hope that the conference will continue to promote and to use all modern communication techniques and media in the most effective manner for swift promulgation of the everlasting gospel. For the three angels' message must fly in the midst of the heavens. Through a sound program of public relations, the communication department has potential to create a favorable climate for acceptance of the message of salvation through Jesus Christ. We pray and hope that the Lord will bless the mighty Trans Orange Conference as we seek to use technology to communicate the end time gospel. God bless you.
The first shall be the last. We came in first to set up. They're all gone. We are the last people out. That's productions for you. It's a sweaty business.